and we're getting back to work here with position battles.
Okay.
Sound like a good idea?
Yeah, I like that.
Like guy for guy, one spot.
Young, old guy maybe?
Yeah, it's like 48 minutes per position.
Yikes.
And sometimes you got two guys going for it. Like Bradley Beal and Jordan Crawford. Here are their numbers in the 2012 preseason. And as you can see.
Similar.
Are you kidding me? They're almost identical.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, so in the regular season, are they going to be putting up virtually identical numbers, or will one separate from the other?
I'm still more leaning towards the younger guy. Love Jordan Crawford. I think he's instant offense. I think he can be in that Jamal Crawford, O.J. Mayo conversation of coming off the bench. But I think Bradley Beal may be your two guard for the bigger part of the future. I just think the way he plays, his body's better, he's younger. I think him and John Wall have a better chance of being on the same page for the future. Bring Jordan Crawford off the bench. That's what I think.
Jordan Crawford was not drafted third overall in any draft, was he?
Last time I checked, no.
Last time I checked, he wasn't either. Bradley Beal is not only the future of the two in Washington, he may be the future face of the franchise.
I agree.
And, you know, John Wall's the number one overall pick, and he's a fantastic player, but he's hurt right now.
Right.
And we don't know how the recovery is going to go. I'm just saying, Beal's a big-time player. And Wall was the first overall pick, which is awesome. But Beal was the third overall pick.
I think both of
those
guys.
These are two big-time guys.
Get John Wall healthy and put both of those guys out there and let them get on the same page. And I think good things are going to happen.
I think Bradley Beal's a nice sleeper in fantasy basketball. He's been threeing in the preseason. He's been stealing the ball in the preseason. And you know I love fantasy gold with the block steals and threes. Just don't look for blocks from Bradley Beal. He is a guard after all. The one position in Atlanta, Teague and Harris. Now, Dennis, we got to put an asterisk by this because if Devin Harris starts at the two,
ooh,
whereas Jeff Teague also starts at the one,
ooh,
this may not be a position battle. So you
That's
tell me,
great...
are both of these guys battling for all the minutes at the one, or is Devin Harris going to slide over to two and make this not a position battle?
Before last week, after having a conversation with Larry Drew, I didn't believe it. I heard people talk about that. Now I'm not believing it. I'm going with Jeff Teague, younger. You know, this is his team, so to speak. Devin Harris on his last leg. You have to prove you got something left in the tank, Devin. We know you was once an all-star. We know you were once one of those top 10 guards in our league. But now you're at that point in your career. If you don't bring it, you could be out the league next year or be sitting on somebody's bench. That's why I was a little, you know, wishy-washy about it. But after talking to Larry Drew, there is a good chance that he may start the two. So it may not be a position battle.
And which to me, I'm kind of high on Teague. I'm not, like, overwhelmingly high on him.
Very similar.
Okay?
He's the last guard of that 09 draft when all the guards came out with Ty Lawson and Drew Holiday and all those guards that draft. He's the last guard that hadn't turned that corner.
Great
and said,
call.
No, he's a keeper. Like Darren Collison, all those type of guys. It's your last chance, Jeff Teague, just like Devin Harris, to prove that you're going to be that mainstay at the point guard position.
Now, I will say this. I think Jeff Teague has shown us enough. Big-time steal guy last year. Started hitting threes last year. The assists need to pop to six or seven. They have to.
Yes,
you can't give us four or five assists from the point guard spot in fantasy basketball. We're nonplussed by that, to be honest with you. So if I think Teague is a mid to late round sleeper, and I think Devin Harris is a late round sleeper, yeah, only because of the possibility of him playing off the ball at the two. Now, let's talk about Kemba Walker versus Ramon Sessions. Ramon Sessions last year, I mean, check this out. You're talking about maybe going from the starting PG of the LA Lakers to the backup PG of the Charlotte Bobcats? Ay, ay, ay. Kemba Walker versus Ramon Sessions. I like Kemba Walker in fantasy basketball. My brother, actually, yesterday, I talked to him on the phone. Bobcat League, he said, you like my pick of Ramon Sessions? He was all kind of excited about it. I said, no, frankly, I don't.
And you know what, Rick? I think your brother may have you on this one because Kemba is still trying to figure out how to run a team. And I think that's what's going to get him on the floor a little bit longer than Kemba. We know you can score.
Really?
We know you can
How
score.
How dare you pick my bro over me, man? He's I'm not sorry. Hosting this show.
I apologize, but big bro, you got this one right. I think Session runs the ball club a little bit better. I think he gets more minutes.
I understand. I was not expecting that take from Dennis Scott. Chris, I love you. One more. Jared Sullinger versus Brandon Bass. And I guess we got to throw Jeff Green in here a little bit, too. Who gets the majority of the minutes at the four in Boston?
Brandon Bass, hands down, clock's closed. Doc Rivers said that's his spot. He's going to be on the floor. He's actually the X factor for the Celtics on a reality standpoint all year long. KG's going to be KG. Paul Pierce is going to be Paul Pierce. Jeff Green's going to be in the mix, but Brandon Bass is that guy that makes that last end of the shot clock when KG gets double teamed. He's the guy that gets that big tip-in rebound. He's that guy that makes that quality shot late in the game. Brandon Bass is going to have a solid year for the Celtics, reality and fantasy.